So I started thinking of all my favorite games in general. Let me preface this by saying I am not your high-tech video gamer. Okay, a gamer to a certain extent, but to me, this is as far as a gamer I am. But seriously, how can you not love the original Nintendo? In virtually any game, you are learning something. You're either learning to be or learning to do. I was excited to find a new game that I thought might become a favorite, that I would like better than Farmville. That would be more closely related to social studies. But the more I thought about it, the more I wanted to create an assessment that would fit for any game I would play in my classroom with my students. So whether it's a Farmville type game where you're out there working with your friends, helping each other build your farm or your civilization in this case, or you're playing a sport, or you're playing a card game, and of course, some type of online game or video game, learning is definitely happening. Within their cooperative learning group, students can come up with a list of things that they can learn to be and learn to do. And then corporately as a class, we can post up all the things they've learned to be and learned to do simply by playing a game. Now, while games and lists are great, we need some life application. In the second phase of assessment, students would have the option to either create a series of drawings within their groups, to create a skit, or some type of audio recording. So this is one of the best ways I think students can learn from each other and have a ton of fun at the same time. Not to mention, the teacher knows exactly how the students are doing, where they're at, what they're learning, and doesn't have a huge stack of papers in front of her to grade.